softwares that I use for editing my videos. So today I am gonna tell you all the softwares and the application that I use to edit my YouTube videos. So the first software is Canva. Canva is a graphic design platform that allows users to create content such as presentations, videos, intros, outros, logos, posters, etc. I usually use it for making intro, outro and thumbnails for my videos. Link for downloading the software is given below in the description. So this is the Canva software in which you can create your content in a form of any multi-purpose video, presentation, poster and etc. So here you can find many template options where which you can create any template such as an invitation or an Instagram story or a poster or a Zoom background also. Then the second option is of create a design, in which you can create a content of your wish and of your custom dimensions such as a poster, a video or a presentation. Then here is a searching software in which you can search your any type of content, and here are many suggested ideas also such as Facebook post, Instagram post, presentation, etc. Then here you have all your designs option in which you can view all your made designs which you have already made. Then here are some of the suggested ideas which are most recently and most used dimensions and recommended ideas. So here are many ideas you can choose, such as invitation, flyer, your story, etc. So this was a whole software of Canva, and it is a very effective software to use for content making. Free YouTube Downloader is a small but effective application that quickly downloads videos without any hiccups. I usually use it for downloading content for my videos, such as I downloaded my videos for my Manchester City montage by this software. Link for the downloading this software is given below in the description. So this is the software of Free YouTube Downloader, and it is a very good software for downloading content for your videos. So I have a link copied in my clipboard of one of my videos, and I will paste it here. Then when you will paste it, after only 2 or 3 seconds you will get its preview. Then you have both the options to download it, to download it as MP4 as video, or to download it as MP3 as audio. So this is a very good software to download the content. And then when you will click on these downloads, here the download will be started, and you can select your automatically that auto download. You can also select that when you will type the link, the auto download of video or audio should start automatically, and then it provides a reference also, that if you want to take the reference of the video, it provides that the description used in that video. You can select it also anywhere, provides a very good suggestions and ideas. So the third software that I use to edit my videos is Shotcut. And Shotcut is a free and open source cross-platform video editing application for free-based Linux, macOS and Windows. Started in 2011 by Dan Dennity, Shotcut is a developed on multimedia framework in development since 2004 by the same author. I usually use it for editing videos which are like montage and contain many videos, and its advantage is that it does not have a watermark. Link for downloading the software is given below in the description. So this is the shortcut software in which you can create and edit your videos by using a timeline. And here I have inserted my one of the videos by this open file option. When you will click on it, a browsing application will open by which you can browse any file, a photo or a video from your software. Then you want to insert this video in a timeline, then you have to click on this and drag it to the timeline and leave it. Then it will become a timeline and you can view its properties here. Then when you click on it, you can increase its speed, you can write comments on it, and you can increase its duration also. Then you can put the aspect ratio of your choice and the frame rate. Then when you have to export the video, you have to click on this export option. Then you can select any format which is favorable to you, but I prefer that if you want a video or a simple video, then you may choose YouTube because it is the best format. It is an MP4 format by which you can export your file, and as you will export your file in the jobs, there will be the exporting will be started. Then here it shows the speed, and if you want to add a sound in it, first you have to open file and add a sound here. Then by this you can click on add audio track, then a audio track will be added. Then when you will add audio track here in the project and drag it again like you did it from the last one, there will be the audio will be inserted and you can trim it by your favorable duration. So this was the software of Shortcut. I have not told all the function, but it has many much to explore and you can do many things in it, like you can ripple edit, then you can split the video and you can create many type of videos from it. So this is the effectful software which you can use for editing. So the fourth software that I use is PowerPoint. Microsoft PowerPoint is a presentation program created by Robert Gaskins and Dennis Austin at a software company named Forethought. It was released on April 20, 1987, initially for Macintosh computers only. Microsoft acquired PowerPoint for $40 million 3 months after it appeared. I usually use it for editing videos and creating presentations. Link for downloading the software is given below in the description.
So this is the PowerPoint software, and I also mostly and recently use it to create my videos, and I know that many of you must be favorable with this software, and many of you must be using it also for your editing. So let's start. So its default name is as presentation 1. Then this is the slide area from which you can insert as many slides you can insert and you want to insert. Then in the intro slide there are two main text boxes, which are the title box and the subtitle box. Then it has various tabs such as file, home, insert, design, etc. So all the tabs have almost equal importance. Like the home tab is mainly used for the editing of the text and the shapes that we insert in the PPT. Then the insert tab is used to insert any content or media in your video, like the audios, screen recording, pictures, videos, equations, etc. You can insert from this tab. Then the design tab defines the whole theme for the PPT. Like if I select this theme is applied to all the slides in the PPT, and as I will insert a new slide, the theme will be applied on that slide also. So it is used to apply the themes, and it is used to define the slide size and to format background also. Then the transition is also an important tab. such as it provides a good way to interact with the audience and entertain them, like when a slide is changed and effect has been placed there so that it would be placed very smoothly. Then the transition tab also helps you to define the time about after how much time the slide will move to the next slide. Then you can apply a sound, a particular sound on a slide also. Then the animation tabs, it is very important tab as it allows us to create any object with an emphasis effect like an entrance or exit or emphasis. Then when you will select object, you will get many options such as, and there are almost four types, that entrance, emphasis, exit and motion paths. Then when you will select anything, then the animation pan also plays an important role in the animation making, as it allows us to reorder the animation in the correct order, and it helps us to do the animation order in a presentable way. Then the slideshow tab allows us to present a slideshow in many forms, such as from the current slide, from beginning, or use the timings or not use the timings, etc. Then the review is about the spelling check and many grammatical mistakes and translates. Then it is about the language part. Then the view, and the view, we can change the view of the whole PowerPoint presentation that we are making. Then in the help, it is the contact support, etc. And then when you will click on any object, its relative tab will also be opened, from which you can edit it mainly. So then another important thing is this quick access toolbar. Then you can add your favorable options in this quick access toolbar. As you can see that I have added save and animation pen because I use them very very frequently and very recently. So this was the whole PowerPoint software in which you can create your videos and presentations very effectively.
So finally, these are my four softwares that I use for editing my videos, which are Microsoft PowerPoint, Free YouTube Downloader, Shortcut, and Canva.